Okay, so this week's topic is decimals. And what are decimals? Well, they're very similar to fractions because they represent a portion of a whole or a portion of a unit. Let's have a look at the word. Here it is, decimals. And look, I've underlined the first three letters, DEC, because they're very important. Have a look at some other words that start with DEC. Decade, decagon, decathlon. What do all of these words have in common? Well, they're all based around the number 10. So decimals is a number system based around the number 10. And in fact, all our numbers are based around number 10. Let's just have a quick look at a normal number here. Look, I have 3,333. And I've written it out here in a place value chart. Okay? So I have my three units, my three tens, my 300s, and my 3,000s. So everything to as you move to the left in normal numbers, your value grows by 10. See, tens are 10 times bigger than units. So this here isn't worth 3, it's worth 30, 3 tens. Whereas the 3 in here is only worth 3 units. And look, hundreds are 10 times bigger than tens. So this is worth 300, which is 10 times bigger than 30. And here are thousands. This is worth 3 thousandths. So that is 10 times more than the 300 here in this hundreds column. Okay, so similarly, decimals is based around number 10. But instead of getting bigger by 10 each time, the place value is getting smaller by 10 each time, okay? So let's have a look. Here I've got one unit, and as I told you, decimals represent a portion of a unit, just like fractions do. But they're based around tenths, hundredths, thousandths, all multiples of 10. They're the only fractions that they link up with. So here I've got a unit split into tenths, just like we covered in fractions, 1 over 10. But in decimals, it's written as 0.1. So a decimal always comes to the right of the decimal point, and our decimal point always goes to the right of the units. Okay? So a decimal point always separates the units and the decimals that follow it. Here I've got my tenths. Okay, so you can see this is split evenly into 10 equal parts, 10 tenths or 10 0.1s. So if I had 3 tenths of this whole unit, okay, so if I had 3 of these bars colored in, I could say I have 3 over 10 or 0.3. Very important that tenths always come one place after this decimal point. If you're dealing with tenths, it's always the first number after the decimal point, the first place, okay? What if I had one whole unit and I had two of these tenths? So I had one unit and two of these tenths. Well then, my unit goes to the left of the decimal point. There it is, one. My decimal point always separates the units and the decimals. And here's my tenths, as I said, always in the first column next to the decimal point, okay? You only have to go as far as tenths in third class, but if you're finding it nice and handy, push on to the hundredths as well, okay? So hundredths are 10 times smaller than tenths. So you can see tenths are 10 times smaller than units. Hundredths are 10 times smaller than tenths. When you get to fifth and sixth class, you'll be doing thousandths, which are 10 times smaller than hundredths. Keeps going on and on to 10 thousandths and 100 thousandths all the way along. Okay, so this is split into 100 equal parts. And each one is either called 100 or 1 over 100, like we would say in fractions, or 0.01. So look at my decimal point to the right of my units. We always said my tenths, it goes in the first column after it, but my hundredths go in the second column. So if I'm dealing with hundredths, I should always have two numbers after the decimal point, even if one of those numbers is zero inside here, okay? Or zero in here. So let's see, if I have eight of these blocks, eight of these squares, I'd represent that as, I've no units, I've no tenths, but I've eight hundredths. So 0.08. No units, no tenths, but I've eight hundredths, okay? And look, I'm double checking, yes, I've two numbers after my decimal point. Okay, what if I had a bigger amount of them, like I had 45 of these hundredths, okay? Well, I remember I've zero units, so it's my zero. My decimal point comes after my units, and now I have 45 hundredths because I can't go past two places after my decimal point. Sometimes people get confused with that, and they start the 45 in the second column. That means they have three numbers after decimal points. No, when you're dealing with hundredths, you only have two numbers after decimal points, so it'll be 0.45. So 45 hundredths is actually the same as 4 tenths and 5 hundredths, okay? But what if I had one whole unit or one whole of something, and then I just had 9 of these little hundredths? Well, then I've got one whole unit, my decimal point always separates my units and my decimals, 0 tenths, and I've got my 9 hundredths there, or 1.09, okay? And it's good when you start to practice your decimals, it's good to say it in fractions and decimal form. So here I've got 1.09 or 1 9/100ths. Or here I have 0.45 or 0 units and 45 hundredths. Okay? So just to recap, if I've got a number, everything to the left of the decimal point is units and they increase in tens and in value, and everything to the right is decimals and they decrease in tens in value per place value column you go in. Okay, so if I was to read out this number that I have here, it would be 3333.22 or 3333 and 22 hundredths. Okay, so the activities that will come up in this video or in the next few videos will include converting fractions to decimals and vice versa. We kind of touched on that a small bit there, but I'll give you a few exercises on that. Ordering decimals, adding and subtracting decimals, and a few little games for them too. And then some more problems with decimals, fractions, multiplication and division, basically the stuff we've done over the last few weeks. Okay, thank you.